Dear students and mathematics lovers, please welcome to the YouTube channel Mathematics Students Helper. In the present video, we discuss Fourier's method. Using that method, you can solve every 4-degree algebraic equations. That means every 4-degree polynomial equation. That means biquadratic. So every biquadratic equation can be solved by using Fourier's method. In the video, at first I give the general approach of that method and then I give examples. I hope that you will understand the video. If this video helps you, then please like it and share it with your friends. If the channel is not still subscribed, please subscribe it to get more videos. However, let's go Fourier's method. Here we consider a biquadratic with binomial coefficient. Binomial coefficient means this is actually here you see that here this is a 4-degree equation, but here the coefficients are a, 4b, 6c, 4d and e. Binomial coefficient means when you use the formula a plus b whole to the power 4, then the coefficients will be 4c0, 4c1, 4c2, 4c3 and 4c4, and there are some a to the power I, b to the power j. So 4c0 means 1, 4c0 means 1, 4c1 means 4, 4c2 means 6, 4c3 means 4, 4c4 means 1. Okay, so this is a biquadratic equation with binomial coefficient. You can consider a simply biquadratic equation with coefficients a, b, c, d, e. Okay, so result must may be slightly changed, but result means the formula must be changed if you consider in general a quadratic, biquadratic. That means if you can consider the coefficient a, b, c, d, e, then the formula must be changed, but the result remains unchanged. Result means the roots of that equations must be unchanged. Okay. However, here I consider the binomial coefficient to get a standard formula or conditions. Okay. So here our target is to write the left hand side of the above equation as a square, as a difference of squares. Difference of squares, here we consider two squares. A x square plus b x plus lambda whole square minus m x plus n whole square. This is our target. Okay, we can express that left hand side in that form. Actually, if you simplify that form, then here you get a square x to the power 4. Actually, a plus b plus c whole square means a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So here a square x to the power 4. The term x to the power 4 arises due to that whole square of ax square. So if you simplify that, then you get a square a to the power 4 x to the power 4 plus dot 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 means here there will be some x cube, some x square, etc. So here I highlight that a square x to the power 4. Actually x square x to the power 4 arises due to whole square of a x square, due to whole square of only a x square. There are no terms containing x to the power 4. Okay, so here you see that here the coefficient of x to the 4 is a square, but here coefficient of x to the 4 is small a. You can treat a as root a whole square, but if we multiply the equation, given equation, by a, then it will be a square x to the power 4 plus 4ab एक्स क्यू प्लस सिक्स ए सी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फोर ए डी एक्स प्लस ए इक्वल टू जीरो, दैट मीन्स दैट इक्वेशन. इफ वी राइट दैट इक्वेशन इन दैट फॉर्म देन दिस इज ए स्क्वायर एक्स टू द फोर प्लस समथिंग. हियर यू सी दैट इफ यू एक्सप्रेस दिस इज इन दैट फॉर्म देन दिस विल बी कैपिटल ए स्क्वायर एक्स स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स कैपिटल ए इक्वल टू स्मॉल ए. ओके, देन आफ्टर एक्सप्रेसिंग द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इन दैट फॉर्म यू कैन फैक्टराइज दैट लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इन टू पार्ट्स, देन इक्वेटिंग ईच फैक्टर टू जीरो यू गेट फोर रूट्स. हाउएवर लेट्स गो इन मेन प्रोसेस. हियर यू कंसिडर द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ए बाई क्वाड्रेटिक विथ with binomial coefficient here. Okay, x to the power plus 4bx cube plus 6cx square plus 4dx plus e equal to 0. Then you have to multiply a in both sides of the above equation. Then we get a square x to the power 4 plus 4abx cube plus 6acx square plus 4adx plus a equal to 0. This is the equation 1. Now, we want to write the left hand side of 1 as difference of 2 squares. Actually, we want to write that portion, okay? That portion as a difference of 2 squares. As ax square plus bx plus lambda whole square plus minus mx plus 10 whole square. Okay, this is the left hand side of equation 1. Now, if you simplify that and if you arrange this is as in polynomial 4, that means something x to the power 4 plus something x cube and so on, then you will get that at first you have to whole square of sum of three terms, that means each square a square plus x to the power 4 plus each square, that means b square x to the power x square. If you take the square of lambda, then this will be lambda. Then 2ab, 2ab means twice ax square into bx. Twice ax square into bx. That means 2abx cube. If you take that two terms, ax square and lambda, that is 2 into ax square into lambda. That means 2a lambda x square. If again you take that two elements, then that will be 2 into bx into lambda, that means 2b lambda x, okay, minus that means m square x square plus n square plus 2mn x. This is the formula of a plus b whole square. If you arrange that expression in the form of polynomial, that means something, this is also a polynomial, but we want to express it in simplified form with something x to the 4, something x cube, etc. etc. You see that here x to the power 4 arises only in that place, that is a square x to the power 4, and also cube also arise only once there, 2abx cube. There are no terms other than that which contains x cube. The only term containing x cube is 2abx cube, and the term containing x to the power 4 is a square x to the power 4. There are no terms other than that two that contains either x to the power 4 or x cube. Okay, then you have to calculate the coefficient of x square. Here this is a term containing x square, this also contains x square. Here this, there are three terms. One is b square x square, then 2a lambda x square, and then minus m square x square. So b square plus 2ab minus m square, coefficient of x square is 2a lambda. So b square plus 2a lambda minus m square into x square. Then coefficient of x here 2b lambda, here 2mn. So 2b lambda minus 2mn into x. And constant part, there is lambda square and there is minus n square. That means lambda square minus n square. Okay. Actually, what is this? This is the left hand side of equation 1. This is the left hand side of equation 1. Okay, and this can be expressed in that form. And when you simplify this, then you get that result. So this is equal to this is. This left hand side of 1 is equal to a square x to the power 4 plus 2ab x cube plus something x square plus something x plus something. Okay. So these two polynomials are equal. Two polynomials are equal only if the coefficients of like power of x are equal. That is, here coefficient of x to the power 4 is a square, small a square. Here capital coefficient of capital coefficient of x to the power 4 is capital A square. So A square must be equal to capital A square. Here coefficient of x cube. That is, here like terms are something x cube. That was like terms. Okay. Here coefficient of x cube is 4ab. Here coefficient of x cube is 2ab. So 4ab equal to 2ab and so on. Okay. So now equating the coefficients of the like powers of x, we get at first coefficient of x to the 4, here capital A square equal to small a square, that means capital A equal to a. Here you can consider a as minus a also. Actually here values of a is plus a or minus a, but here you consider capital A as small a, but you can consider it as minus a also. Okay. From coefficient of x cube, we get 2ab equal to 4ab. That means here we put a equal to small a. That means 2 small a, b, capital B, equal to 4 small a, small b. Here 2a, 2 small a, here 4a. So 4a, here 2a simplified, this will be 2b. That means capital B means 2b. Please calculate, you have to calculate the problem yourself in your exercise book with pen. Please calculate yourself, then it will be easy to you. Okay. Then coefficient of x square, b square plus 2a lambda minus m square equal to 6ac. From that relation, we take m square. Sorry, here we put 2b in the place of b. So 2b whole square, that means 4b square plus 2a lambda. You have to put capital A equal to small a. So this is 2a lambda, okay, minus m square plus 6ac. Then m square equal to 4b square plus 2a lambda minus 6ac. Similarly, coefficient of x, here coefficient of x is 2b lambda minus 2mn, here 4ad. So 2b lambda minus 2mn equal to 4ad. Implies that 2mn equal to 2mn, if you take 2mn in the right hand side, then 2b lambda minus 4ad. 2b, capital B means small 2b, 2 small b. Okay, this is equal to 2b lambda. 2 capital B means 2 small b lambda minus 4ad. If you take common 4, this will be mn equal to, sorry, here actually 2 is cancelled in both sides. Here, if you take common, this will be 4 into b lambda minus ad. But in left hand side, there are 2 mn. So after cancelling 2 both sides, you get mn equal to 2 into b lambda minus ad. Finally, equating the constants lambda square minus n square equal to ae, that means n square equal to n square equal to lambda square minus ae square. Actually, what is our target? Our target is to find capital A, capital B, lambda, m, n, m and n. But we can derive the values of capital A and capital B. Now we have to derive the values of lambda, m and n. For that purpose, we consider that three relations: m square equal to something, n square equal to something. Here this is the given equation. Then we multiply a in both sides of a. Then we express the left hand side of equation 1 as a difference of two squares, okay, then you have to equate the coefficients of like terms of x, then you get capital A equal to small a, capital B equal to 2 small b, and m square equal to something, mn equal to something, n square equal to something. Okay, now we have to find, in previous slide I say that we have to find capital A, capital B, lambda, m and n. Okay, so here I get capital A and capital B in terms of small a and small b. Now we have to find the values of m, n and lambda satisfying that three relations 2, 3 and 4. At first we have to eliminate m and n from the above three equations 2, 3 and 4. This is a printing mistake, typing mistake, 2, 3 and 4. We get that. That means actually to eliminating mn, we consider the relation mn whole square, mn whole square equal to m square n square. Mn whole square means 4 into b lambda minus ad whole square. Okay, this is mn whole square. 2 square means 4, b lambda minus ad whole square. Okay, this is mn whole square equal to m square here into n square. That means this is m square, I write down it here, this is n square, lambda square minus a. Clearly this is a cubic. So after eliminating m and n from above three relation, we get that relation. This is a cubic of cubic in lambda. 3-degree polynomial equation in lambda. Because here if you simplify in left hand side, there will be lambda square. Here lambda square, if you multiply that two factors, then you will get something lambda cube. So here highest power of lambda is 3. So this is a cubic. You know that every cubic has at least one real root. We get at least one real root. Why? Because you know that complex root occurs in a algebraic equation with real coefficient as a pair. That means if a plus ib is a root, if a plus ib is a root, then a minus ib also a root. If a plus ib is a root of the equation, then a minus ib is also another root. So complex roots occurs in pair form. That means number of complex number in a polynomial equation is an even number. That is, number of complex root of an algebraic equation is either 0 or 2 or 4, etc. But here the degree of equation is 3 cubic. So number of roots is also 3. So number of complex root must be 0 or 2. That is, either it has no complex root or it has 2 complex root. Okay. Since there are 3 roots, so when it has 2 complex root, then number of real root must be 1. And when it is 0 complex root, that is when it has no complex root, then the roots are real, that is, then there are 3 real roots. So as a result, every cubic has at least one real root. We have to find it. Suppose lambda is equal to lambda 1 is a real value of lambda. We consider lambda 1 as a real value of lambda, or is a as a real root of that relation. If you put the value of lambda equal to lambda 1 in 2, 3 and 4, we get m and n. If you put the value of lambda here, if you put lambda here, then you get m square, you get mn, you get n square. So you have to find the values of mn satisfying all the three equations. Suppose the value of mn are m1 and n1 respectively. Okay. Now we see the Ferris method at a glance. Here this was the given equation. After multiplying small a, you get the equation 1. Then our target was to express the left hand side of that form as a difference of 2 square. So here we write this is as a difference of 2 square. Okay, this is, that means the equation 1 can be written as ax square. Before that, I write down here the values of capital A, capital B, lambda, m, and n. Capital A, capital B, lambda, m, n. So this is the actually left hand side of equation 1. Equation 1 means given equation. Actually here difference is here multiply A in both sets of A. So since this is the left hand side of equation 1, so equation 1 can be written as, actually this is given equation actually. Given equation can be written as in that form equation 1. So given equation can be written as this is equal to 0. Actually this is the left hand side. Here I write down just small a in the place of capital A, small 2b in the capital B, lambda 1 in the place of lambda, small m1 in the place of lambda, and n1 for n. Because we find that value satisfying all the relations. What are the relations? The relations are actually the relation you get by computing or equating the coefficients of like powers of x. Okay. Now we have to factorize that relation. A plus b into a minus b. This is capital A, this is b, a square minus b square. A plus b into a minus b. So if you equate that relation, this is actually a quadratic, second degree algebraic equation. This is also another quadratic. So if you equate this is to zero, then you get two roots. And if you equate that to zero, then you also get another two roots. As a result, there are total four roots. Okay. So now ax square plus 2bx, this is actually first factor, is 0 gives 2 roots, and another 2 roots can be obtained from the equation that equal to 0. Okay. This is the general approach of Ferrari's method. So this was given equation, after multiplying a you get that, then we express the above equation in that form. Okay. Just see to a matter. Here you have to express that form in these forms. Okay. Here this will be ax square and this will be 2b. Now actually I give a note. This is very important, the note. After using that note, we actually solve the Ferrari's method. This will help you. Actually there was three unknowns, capital A, capital B, lambda, m, n. Actually by inspection you can find capital A, capital B. How? Let's go. If we choose A equal to 1, then the equation 1 can be written as, if you put a equal to 1, this will be x to the power 4 plus 4bx cube plus 6cx square plus 4dx plus e. Or if you put here a equal to 1, then you get the same result. Okay. Actually, when in an equation there are some another number, suppose 2, 3, 4, etc. So you have to divide the whole equation by that small a. If there are minus 2. Suppose minus 2x square plus something. So you have to divide whole equation by minus 2. Then the coefficient of x to the 4 must be equal to 1. So what is speciality for a equal to 1? Actually, you see that this can be expressed in that form. So here you have to put a equal to 1. So you get x square plus 2bx plus lambda 1 whole square. X square plus 2bx plus lambda 1 whole square minus m1x plus n1. Just I put here m in the place of m, n in the place of n1, lambda in the place of lambda. Here our main observation is, here you see that since here is coefficient of x to the 4 is 1, here coefficient of x square is 1. Most important thing is that here coefficient of x cube is 2b. Here coefficient of x cube is 4b, but here coefficient of x is 2b. That is, here the coefficient of x is half of coefficient of x cube. Coefficient, this is the more important thing you have to observe. Here the coefficient of x cube, coefficient of x is 2b, which is half of 4b. So when you express the given equation in that form, you have to write at first x square, since there is x to the 4. If there is some constant present, suppose 7 is present here. So you have to divide 7 in both sides. Okay. Then this is the x to the 4. So at first I write x square, and x square plus something x. X something will be half of coefficient of x cube, and the remainings are unchanged. Then you have to find lambda mn. So after using that relation or that approach, you have to find only lambda m and n. Capital A and capital B is derived automatically. Just let's go in an example, then I hope you will understand it clearly. Okay. Here the example is, here you consider a 4-degree equation. Okay. In the solution, given equation is that, this is the given equation. You have to solve it by Ferrari's method. Solve the equation that in Ferrari's method. Okay. So at first you have to write this is a difference of 2 square. Above equation can be written as, you see that here this is x to the 4. So I write x square plus 2x. 2x why? Actually in previous slide, you see that previous slide, please, sorry. Okay. Here previous slide there was a 4bx cube, but here 2bx. That means coefficient of x must be half of coefficient of x cube. Okay. So this was the equation. So this can be written as x square plus half of x cube. Half of 4. That means coefficient of, you have to consider coefficient of x cube, and then you have to half of it. That means x square plus 2x. 2, why 2? 2 is the half of 4. Okay. So x square plus 2x plus lambda square minus mx plus n whole square. Now we have to find lambda m and n. Well, lambda m and n are constant. Now if you simplify the equation 2, then you get a plus b plus c whole square. That means x to the 4 plus 4x square plus, actually this is whole square of x square, x to the 4, 2x whole square, that means 4x square, lambda whole square means lambda square. You have to multiply that two term, that means, and then multiply 2. So 2 into x square into 2x, that means 4x cube. And if you take x square and lambda, then this will be 2 lambda x square. This is 2 lambda x square. And you have to take, if you take 2x and lambda, then you get 4 lambda x. Okay. This is the expression of that. And mx plus n whole square means m square x square plus 2mnx plus n square. Okay. If you arrange that in that form, something x to the power 4 plus something x cube, then here x to the power 4 and x cube arise only once. Here x square is here present here only. Here x cube, 4x cube. So x to the x cube plus 4x cube. Please notice that here x to the power 4 and 4x cube. That means coefficient of x to the 4 and coefficient of x cube remain same, remains unchanged as the given equation. Okay, this happens because you have to take here 2, that means half of 4, so you get 4x cube. Actually x cube occurs only when you multiply 2x square, 2x and 2. There are no terms including x cube. X cube arises due to product of x square and x cube, and this happens only if you multiply x square with 2x and then multiply 2. Okay, so this will match automatically. Now coefficient of x square is here 4, here 2 lambda, here minus m square. So 4 plus 2 lambda minus 2 m square minus m square to x square. And coefficient of x is here 4 lambda x, here 2 m n x. So 4 lambda minus 2 m n x plus constant is lambda square minus n square. Okay, actually this is the given equation in another form. Since here coefficient of x to the 4 is same, automatically the remaining coefficient must be same. That is, if you equate the coefficients of like powers of x, then you get here 1 1 are same, 4 4 are same. So 4 plus 2 lambda minus m square must be equal to minus 6, since 1 and 2, actually this is the equation, sorry, since 1 2 means actually this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. No, actually it is correct. Actually this is 2. After simplifying you get that relation. Okay, it's correct. Since 1 and 2 are identical, 2 means that equation. Yeah, this is that equation 2. If you arrange equation 2 in that form, you get that relation. Since 1, 2 are identical, so 1 and that equation is identical. So equating the coefficient of like powers of x, you get here, since that two coefficients are same, here coefficient of x to the 4 is 1, here is also 1, so remaining coefficients must be equal. So at first 4 plus 2 lambda minus m square equal to minus 6, equating the coefficient of m square, coefficient of x square, so m square equal to 10 plus 2 lambda. This is the equation 3. If you consider the term containing x, there 4 lambda minus 2 mn, here 20. Okay, so after taking common 2, this will be 2 lambda, this is mn, this is cancel after, this will be 10. So mn equal to 2 lambda minus 10. 2 lambda minus 10 mn. And taking constant term, you get lambda square minus n square equal to plus 8. Here constant is lambda square minus n square, here plus 8. So n square equal to lambda square minus 8. Okay. Now we have to eliminate mn from 3, 4 and 5. For that purpose, we use the relation mn whole square is m square into n square. That means 2 lambda minus 10 whole square equal to 10 plus 2 lambda minus lambda into lambda square minus 8. 10 plus 2 lambda into lambda square minus 8. If you take common 2, so this will be 4 into lambda minus 5 whole square. Here you have to common 2 from that. So this will be 5 plus lambda and lambda square minus 8. Then after simplifying, this will be here 2, here is 4. So after adjusting, this will be plus 2 and this will be 1. So 2 into lambda minus 5 whole square, that means 2 into 20 lambda square plus 25 minus 10 lambda. Here 2 is cancelled from that. Here 5 into lambda square minus 8, that means 5 lambda square minus 40. Here lambda into that means lambda cube minus 8 lambda. Okay. After arranging, this is something lambda cube, something lambda square, you get that result. This is a cubic, so you get at least one real root of the equation. Here I solve that cubic by using vanishing method, or you can say the zero put or indifferent another name. However, what are the process? This is actually trial and error method. we have to put the values of lambda, which is a factor of 90. So we have to check in which particular value of lambda the equation 6 is satisfied. Here we have to put at first lambda equal to 1, then lambda equal to 2, then lambda equal to minus 2, and then lambda equal to 3. So here if I put lambda equal to 3, this is satisfied. Okay. What is the approach? Just since lambda equal to 3 is satisfied, so gapping one line, I write lambda minus 3 three times. Actually, since lambda equal to 3 is satisfy that equation, so lambda minus 3 minus 3 will be a factor of that. Okay. Now, just write lambda minus 3 three times. Then you have to adjusting that expression. At first, I multiply here lambda square. Why? Because there is lambda cube. So you have to multiply lambda square. So lambda cube minus 3 lambda square. But here is plus 3 lambda square. So you have to add here plus 6 lambda square. So I write down here plus 6 lambda square. Since this is plus 6 lambda square, you have to find here 5. You have to find you here 6 lambda square. So you have to add here 6 lambda. As a result, this will be 6 lambda square. So I write down here 6 lambda. When you write 6 lambda, this is matched with that 6 lambda square. But 6 lambda into minus 3 give you minus 18 lambda. But there is plus 12. So you have to adjust it. For that purpose, I write down here 30 lambda. If you write down 30 lambda, then as a result, this will be 12 lambda. But you have to find it here. So if you multiply here 30, then you get 30 lambda. And then minus 3. This is minus 19, 30 into 3, which is matched with that expression. Okay, this is equal to 0. So taking common lambda minus 3 into something, lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 30 equal to 0. Actually, you can find another root of the equation, that is another values of lambda besides 3, but I need one real root. So I get here lambda is equal to 3 is a real root. Okay, you can find another real root if there are, but if not, then no problem. Lambda equal to 3, you can choose. When in a cubic there are 3 real roots, so you can choose any one of them. Okay, if you choose lambda equal to another root, actually in that equation there are b square means 36 4ac. Actually this equation has no real root. Actually equation 6 has only one real root. So you have to put lambda equal to 3 here. There are many problems where the equation 6 has 3 real root. So you can choose any of them. Okay, if you choose other root, suppose here 3 is a root and 4 is a root, but here 4 is not a root, suppose 4 is a root. So when you put lambda equal to 3, you get different set of values of mn. When you put lambda equal to 4, if you put lambda equal to 3, then you get a set of values of mn. But when you put lambda equal to 4, then you get another set of values of mn. Okay, but the result remains unchanged. Result means the roots of the given equation remains unchanged. Okay, however, here we take lambda equal to 3. This was the equation 6. Clearly lambda equal to 3 is a real root of the equation 6. Lambda equal to 3 is a real root of the equation 6. Now if we put lambda equal to 3 in the relation 3, 4 and 5, we get in 3 you see that m square equal to 10 plus 2 lambda. Lambda is equal to here, lambda is 3. 3 into 2 means 6, that means 16. So m square equal to 16. So m equal to plus minus 2, plus minus 4.
if you put lambda equal to 3, then this will be mn equal to 2 into 3 means 6 minus 10, that means minus 4. If you put here lambda equal to 3, then n square equal to 3 square minus 8, that means 9 minus 8, that means 1. Okay. So n equal to plus minus 1. Here you see that the product of mn is minus 4, that means negative. But here m has two values, two options, n and n has also two options. But if you take m as plus 4 and n as plus 1, as a result mn must be plus 4. If you take positive sign in both of cases m and n, then what will be the value of mn? This will be plus 4, but here we find that the value of mn is minus 4. So you have to take values of mn in opposite sign. If you take m equal to plus 4, then you have to take n equal to minus 1. If you take m equal to minus 4, then you have to take n equal to minus 1. Okay. However, since mn equal to minus 4, we can take m equal to 4, n equal to minus 1. So we get lambda equal to 3, and using that lambda you get m equal to 4 and n equal to 1. Therefore, given equation 2 can be written as, actually what was the 2? Actually this is 2, x square plus 2x plus lambda whole square minus mx plus n whole square. Here you have to put the values of lambda mn, lambda equal to 3, here you have to put lambda equal to 3 and m equal to 4, n equal to minus 1. As a result, you get x square plus 2x plus 3 whole square minus 4x minus n whole square, 4x minus 1 whole square. This is the equation. So given equation can be written as in that form. Okay, just here put lambda equal to 3 here, m 4 and n in minus 1, just you get that expression. Okay, so you have to factorize it. If this is the difference of 2 square, so that plus that into that minus that, that means x square plus 2x plus 3 plus 4x minus 1, and that minus 4x minus of 4x minus 1, that means minus 4x plus 1. If you simplify, you get x square plus here 6x plus 2, here minus 2x plus 4, so x square plus 6x plus 2, x square minus 2x plus 4. Now at first, if you equate this to 0, you get two roots of x, two values of x. You can use Siddharajara formula, minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac by 2a, here minus b means 6, minus 6 plus minus b square means 36 minus 4 into 1 into 2, 8 by 2a. Then you get minus 6 plus minus, this is 28, 2 root 7. So minus 3 plus minus root 7, and x square minus 2x plus 4, you find x equal to minus of minus 2, that is plus 2 plus minus root under minus 2 whole square means 4. Minus 4 into 1 into 4, 16 by 2, that means 2 plus minus root 12. 12 means 4 into 3, that means 2 root 3, and there are minus 1, minus 1, that means I. So as a result, this is 2 root 3 I. Okay, 2 root 3 I. So after dividing 2, you get 1 plus minus root 3 I. So you get 4 roots, there are 2 roots, and there are also another 2 roots. Hence the roots of the given equation are minus 3 plus minus root 7 and 1 plus minus root 3i. I hope that you understand the whole video. If you have any query, any question, then you can mail me or you can write in comment box. Thank you for watching whole the video.